So I'm sitting here in a pile of rocks at the bottom of Grand Canyon. And there's rocks in Grand Canyon. We have all three kinds. We have the sedimentary rocks, we have the igneous rocks, and we have metamorphic rocks. One of the cool ways to really think about a metamorphic rock is actually a Bible verse. Romans chapter 12, verse 2 tells us, "Do not conform any longer to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Then we will know what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will." And there's a beautiful, beautiful analogy there, because the word transform that we have in English, the Greek word, the original word is metamorphos, which is this idea of being transformed, right? So we think about this rock, this metamorphic rock that's part of the basement rock and the foundation rock of the continents and found in Grand Canyon. That's a rock that has been transformed. It has changed from its original condition. And guess what? It was heat and pressure that transformed it. You know, it's the same root word that we have for the metamorphic process that a caterpillar goes through to become a butterfly, and then the caterpillar is transformed and changed. And this verse, Romans chapter 12, verse 2, calls us out and says, we're to be transformed. So this metamorphic rock is this beautiful analogy and this picture of calling us out that we need to be like that metamorphic rock. We need to be transformed. We need to be changed, right? When we give our lives to Jesus Christ, the old is gone, the new has come, we come become a new creation. But just like the metamorphic rock is transformed, it's metamorphosed by heat and pressure. And the Bible tells us that we are going to be salted by fire. It is the heat and the pressure of life that transforms us, that brings us into a new understanding of ourselves and the majesty and the glory and the compassion and the presence of God. And the struggles that we face really are our means and our opportunity to become more like Christ. You see, a caterpillar was never created just to be a caterpillar. But in order for that caterpillar to become the butterfly, to be able to get up in the air and to fly and all the beauty of those colors, it's got to go through a lonely, dark struggle called the cocoon. And there's no way around the cocoon. The caterpillar can't say, "God, I really want to be a butterfly, but I really don't want to go through that struggle. I really don't want to crawl into that dark, lonely place." You can't go around the cocoon in order to become the butterfly. Just like we can't go around the cross. Christ took on everything so that we could be transformed, so that we could be made new. And the light and momentary struggles of this world are transforming us, revealing to us the majesty and power of God, so that we can, as Isaiah says, soar on eagle's wings. So as you think about the rocks of the earth that you just run around on and maybe don't even think about much at all, today, think about those rocks, specifically a metamorphic rock that's calling us out, according to Romans chapter 12, verse 2, to be transformed. Then, and only then, will we embrace the life that Christ died for us to have.